home to some fantastic art galleries. But just a short ferry ride away is a seaside village that a whole community of artists call home.
Welcome aboard, Sally.
Thank you. The Cronulla is the cutest ferry, operating between Cronulla and Bundeena. It's also the oldest commuter ferry working to a regular timetable in Australia. Steve, how long have you been the skipper of this ferry?
12 years now. It's a nice waterway. It's a fairly nice berm on it and, yeah, a lot burn on the water.
Before Europeans arrived, the Darawal people lived and thrived along this pristine waterway, living off a bounty of fresh seafood. Bundeena is also an indigenous word meaning noise like thunder, thought to reflect the sound of the waves crashing against the rocks.
Thank you. Sal, welcome to Bundeena.
It's so pretty here.
We've put on the show for you today. Look at that weather. How gorgeous is it?
You know, I've never been here before.
Haven't you? No. Oh, you won't want to leave now.
Rose is one of the many artists living and working in Bundeena. Rose, how long have you lived here for?
My husband and I retired here 4.5 years ago. When I realised all the artists that live here and well-known artists and how many and that there was an art trail and we also have a festival once a year as well, yeah. I was just in my element and I started volunteering and yeah, it just led to other things.
The Bundeena Maianbar Art Trail has been operating for several decades now. And while you can grab a trail map at the wharf, today I'm trailblazing with Rose, who's also the trail president. Bundeena is a charming village full of cafes and shops, but we're on a mission to meet the artists. And our first stop is Art Gecko, the studio of artist Peter Mulder.
Hello, welcome to Studio 7
on
the Art Trail.
Peter, you are the founder of the Art Trail, aren't you?
Yes, there's something that needed to be done for the community here because there's over 100 artists in Bundeena Maianbar.
And I believe it's the oldest continuing art trail in Australia.
That's right, yes. Like every month for 20 years.
Yeah. Peter's studio overflows with colourful works, many inspired by his travels to the Kimberley in Western Australia. If you're lucky, you might even get to collaborate with Peter. Some artists use paintbrushes, but others like to use a credit card.
Like this one.
My favourite tool. The artists here are great talents, generous hosts, and there are some real characters like Bob. Bob, you call Bundeena paradise by the sea, don't you?
Well, here I am at the age of 40. I've been living in England for 20 years. I came down to Bundeena, I dived into the sea as the ferry left at 6 o'clock, and I thought, this is bloody paradise by the sea. It's just unbelievable.
Bob's art features many local sites, like the Cronulla Ferry.
It is just like a dream. And I painted.
But it's real, it's all here. So this is your muse, it inspires you. The Bundeena and Maianbar artists are a fascinating bunch, with some hailing from across the globe, like celebrated Chinese artist Zhao Wei Shen. Purpose-built to accommodate this giant artwork, Zhao Wei's house and studio is incredible. Zhao Wei, wow, your home is like an art gallery. I mean, look at these walls.
Like a palace.
Like a palace, yes, you're very lucky. Incredible. Did you build your home to be like this?
Of course, it's my dream, yes.
Yeah. So you could paint the walls?
Yeah, this is my last play, big project.
Wow.
Yes.
Adorning the walls is Zhao Wei's current historical work in progress, the Tower of Babel. So you've already spent a year on this one and it's another 3 years until you finish.
Yeah, this is already in the last stage. So this is the 1 year, another 3 years finish that one.
Zhao Wei is also a renowned portrait artist, having painted some of the world's most famous faces. You've painted Princess Mary, the Prime Minister, Pope Francis. Have you got a favourite?
Governor General, Peter Cosgrove. I'm very lucky. I can meet a lot of important person. So I'm very lucky. It's very lucky, yes.
Zhao Wei isn't the only artist in this house. His wife, Lan Wang, is also an accomplished painter, depicting vastly different subjects with an emphasis on nature. The last next ferry leaves Bundeena in the afternoon, but I'm staying here at the house.
But it's not just any old home. Impressive, huh?
The house on the rock is a breathtaking dwelling, offering guests 270-degree views out over Port Hacking to the Pacific. There's three large bedrooms with water views from every room and a huge open-plan kitchen, living and dining room overlooking the wraparound deck where the sunsets are pure magic.
Art, nature, food and bubbles. It really is paradise by the sea.
Enjoy beautiful Bundeena this winter. For all the info on this fantastic weekender, jump on sydneyweekender.com.au.